Like I said, June is probably one of the best months for a smorgasbord on the river. One of my favorite patterns is the sulfur. And this sulfur, I sort of cheat. I take Art Flick's variants, and I just take off the wings for the sulfur, and it works well as an attractor fly and as an imitator. Floats high on the surface. Use them in size 16s and 14s. And to build this, very simple fly, like a guide fly. Ginger sulfur hackle for a tail, fibers, and ginger hackle for the hackle. And then simply take a goose biot and wrap it for the body. It gives you a natural segmentation. It's usually a high floater and it works on everything. Since you do it with a sulfur, you can also do it in a dun-colored one, imitating an isonychia, or you can also do it in a white-colored pattern to imitate a light cahel. Again, I sort of cheat by taking the wings off, but at this time of the year, I want to catch fish and I don't want to tie flies. Other patterns, same situation that you got, are caddis flies. And caddis are going to come out all over this time of the year in a whole bunch of flavors and varieties. Tan wing, tan body, cream wing, cream body, and then you can start alternating on the body colors. Olive, gray, dark gray, slate, brown. Same thing with the wings. You make it the flavor of the day. It's just like going to Ben and Jerry's. When you're not fishing dry flies, there's only two go-to nymphs that I use. And that is a pheasant tail, which can be used all year long. And I cheat on this one too by enhancing it to make it go down to the bottom. And that being by adding a dumbbell to it, a little different. If you're in really shallow water, take the dumbbell off. Traditional pheasant tail, pheasant tail body, a little gold wire rib. I put a thorax on it to imitate a stonefly, and I use ostrich hurl. We never use enough ostrich hurl. And then I put that wing case over it of another piece of pheasant tail, just like Frank Sawyer did in England during the 50s. Killer pattern, couple different variations and colors, and they do catch fish. The other thing is, we've got stoneflies coming off, and another traditional pattern is a hare's ear nymph. I do the same thing. Take hare's ear nymph body, use a little turkey tail for the tail, wrap it up, use another thorax to imitate the legs on maybe a cream or a yellow stonefly, and use the ostrich, and then go over the top with also some more turkey tail as a wing pad. Hare's ear nymphs, pheasant tail nymphs, two great patterns to have on the river, weighted, unweighted, and eliminate all the bulk out of your fly box and build a June fly box when you go. And any other patterns, bring them with you. But this is the box to bring.